Hi, this is Code Tutor. My name is Anil Deshpande. I am the co-author of Composing Mobile Apps, which is an Android mobile application development book. In this particular video, I am going to talk about what are intents and where they are used. Before talking about what are intents, I will just talk about various scenarios where you have to use intents. Assume that you have an activity and you want to trigger another activity. You have to use an intent. You have an activity and you want to trigger a service. You have a broadcast receiver and you want to trigger that particular broadcast receiver. Once again, you have to use an intent. So it is quite apparent that intent are the most important concepts in Android. So intents are at the very center of how various Android components communicate with one another. You want to trigger an activity, service, broadcast receiver, all of these have to be started or triggered using an intent. Programmatically speaking, intent is just like any other Java class. You can see the documentation and it's just a subclass of object. Intent is a message passing mechanism in Android that helps various Android components to talk to one another seamlessly. So having understood theoretically what intents are, now let us get into a demo. I already have a activity ready, and in that particular activity I have a button, and when you click on that particular button, it is just showing me a toast message. Now what I want to do is, I will have another activity, I will create another activity, and that activity will get triggered on click of this particular button. For that, let me create another layout file, layout resource file, layout activity second.xml. And in this particular layout, let me have a text view with width match parent, height wrap content, and ID. Text view message. So this is how this particular text view or the layout would look like. As of now, we don't have any content. Just for the simplicity purpose, we will put a sample text to just see how it looks like. And now let me create a class which extends activity. That is how you create an activity in Android. So activity second. Let this class extend activity. One of the main method is the onCreate method that you need to override. And once you create the method onCreate, you have to set the content. You can see in the main activity also, we have set the content by using setContentView. So in the second activity, once again, we have to setContentView, and you have to give the name of the layout, which is r.layout.layoutSecond. And that is how you are setting the content for the second activity. And just let me change the text here so that when it gets loaded, the message becomes quite clear. Let me write, this is a second activity. I have now created another activity, set the content. The next part is I have to declare it in the manifest file. If you don't declare your activity in the manifest file, then at the runtime you will get an exception. So for that, let me open the manifest file, activity, second activity, done. Now let us go to the main activity. Instead of toasting it, I will trigger the second activity. For that, let me create an intent, second act intent. You have to call a constructor. The first parameter is always the context. So you can pass the current context. And the second parameter is the another activity name that you want to call. That is activity second dot class. So the intent is ready. This is how we have created the intent. So it is this intent that is going to help me to trigger the second activity. To trigger the second activity, there is a method called startActivity. You have to pass the intent. That's it. We have the code which is going to work. Let me run this. And you will observe that when I click on the next activity button, it is actually going to load the second activity. You can see that the second activity got loaded. So it is through intent that you load another activity. In the same way as you have triggered a activity here, you could have triggered another service. Or if you broadcast a intent, then you can trigger a broadcast receiver. So this is how the concept of intents are used in Android. The kind of intent that we used here is called as explicit intent, because you can see that we have clearly mentioned explicitly which particular class that we want to trigger or which particular activity that I want to trigger. There is another way of doing this. It is called as implicit intent. I am going to address those concepts probably in the next video. So please leave your comments and help me understand what you would like to hear more in the future classes. Thanks, and I am going to leave the GitHub code below in the information section, so from where you can download the demo code and you can work with at your own pace and time. So thank you for listening. Please leave your comments, share your thoughts, and let me know what else you would like to see in this particular channel. Thanks.